The Response Innovation Lab is a global collaborative platform whose founding and core members include World Vision, Save the Children, Oxfam, and Civic. Our purpose is to understand humanitarian challenges and then to broker these challenges with solutions that show promise and are fit for the context. The Response Innovation Lab partnered with the Somali WASH cluster to understand and prioritize the top challenges in the sector.
In Puntland, both the water quantity and quality is a big challenge. The drought has been cyclical and it was coming every 10 years, but this time it is almost every year.
The occurrence of droughts that make difficult to community to access water, and the lack of water will increase.
There is no surface water, and the boreholes themselves, the water table is going down every year. Boreholes here are very expensive and there are very few.
Markaad waxa dhiga laba cel isku jiraan 78 km taasoo community dib ku noqotay si biyaha u soo qaadan lahaayeen oo u keen lahayn meel fog fog. Most of the boreholes, their water are not suitable for drinking.
The salinity level is normally recommended around 800 microsiemen per centimeter. But here, most of the boreholes were having more than 3,000. The more people drink high saline water, the more they are getting dehydrated because of the saltiness.
We are really important to have a data or map of water quality.
Real-time data from across Puntland is not there. Most of the boreholes are remote, and security across Puntland hinders us to go to measure and come up with the data collection.
The cluster members identified the challenge of understanding and getting real-time data on water quality and quantity as an urgent need. The Response Innovation Lab then researched the world to find the most appropriate system that was fit for the context. We then partnered with World Vision to field test this system in a pilot for the first time in the Somali context.
There are sensors which are installed deep in the borehole, both the water level sensors and the electrical conductivity, the temperature sensors are in a small probe which is attached to a data cable inserted into the borehole. And the cables connecting the sensor with a communication unit which is installed outside the borehole.
We installed 9 sites in 5 regions in Puntland.
So the remote sensors are measuring water quantity and quality.
The water level, conductivity, the salinity, the total dissolved solutions of the inside of the water.
And we receive the data remotely using the 3G enabled internet system. That real-time data is very, very useful.
Waxay yeelay waxay fududeynaysaa inaad xog badan aad heshid, especially marka uu jiro xilliyada abaaraha ama xilliyada biyo-yaraanta ceelasha ay ku dhacayaan. Wuxuu ku fududeynayaa in la ogaado in ceelasha ay ku xiran yihiin inay biyo-yaraan soo food saari rabto, in graafkooda biyaha uu kor u kacsan yahay.
Waxayna siin karaan inaan fursad ama fakar u fakarro sidaan dadkeena u gaarsiin lahayn biyo wanaagsan cabi karayaan.
In the long run, they will be benefiting the entire region and the country in setting early warning system, including the drought. In all the boreholes, the preliminary data shows very high level of conductivity, which is not recommended for drinking purpose. Second, we are observing a high drawdown. The dynamic water level is going down every time, and we are providing the government that information so that they are preparing for some disaster and responses. Based on the preliminary data analysis, we communicated both the government and donors. It's attracting their interest. That's why we got also additional funding for scale up of this project into Somaliland until we hand over the system officially to the government.